So I just feel bad when I discover that after participating in my national duty, I found myself this kind of disability problem. Yeah, I'm Stephen Alau, a graduate of Adekunle Ajayi University. I graduated 2017 and been mobilized to Kebbi State for my NYC. 2018. During the recent election, I'm among the selected core members, selected as an ad hoc staff for INEC NYC ad hoc staff. So I was posted for an electoral duty at Wasagu, Danko Wasagu, Tudu Bichi 1. The word is Tudu Bichi 1. So we have participated on the first presidential election, senatorial election, and House of Assembly election, that is House of Representative election. But during the second phase of the election, which is the governorship election and the state House of Assembly election, so it was then I was traveling from my place to the electoral duty to get the material needed for the election at Wasagu. So it was then I had an accident along the roadside. I was taken to an hospital nearby in the local, in the community. So, but they don't have enough facilities to take care of me. I realized that as I opened my eyes to the ceiling, I saw two women by my side, right side and left side. They were using the fan to fan my face. Then I woke up. It was then I realized that I had an accident, and I was trying to look at my chest. I just saw my chest with a pool of blood, only singlet in my body. But I got to know later that two people died during the accident. So, and I vomited blood on the spot of the accident from my nostril, from my mouth, and from the ear. As I'm talking to you now, it's more than a year that the accident happened, but still I have an issue with my rib, my back, and my hair, even my eyes, because of the accident. So it was there, from that hospital in the local government, they transferred me through a military ambulance to Usman Afodio Teaching Hospital in Sokoto State. So I was admitted to a neurosurgical department, which they diagnosed my brain because my brain was shifted. So they set my brain with an engine. So I have a fracture of the rib. Blood is even stick to my hair. The blood that was gushing out blocked the whole hair totally. I now discovered that I just need to relocate down to Lagos State for better treatment, for continuation of the treatment. So it was then I now informed the state coordinator. I couldn't even stand up. I couldn't bend. The man at NYC assigned to me, the state coordinator assigned to me, Mr. Francis, was the one throwing off my pits, my urine and everything. He was with me throughout of the incident. So when I now come back, travel down to Lagos State, I now continue my treatment. And up to now, it's more than a year, I still have challenges, you know, a life-threatening illness that is battling with my life. I couldn't breathe very well most time. I couldn't see from long distance objects. The more I sleep, the more I discover that my back is paining me. So I now go to the doctor again to tell him. He said it's because of the accident. I have rib fracture. So they recommended orthopedic bed for me. That's the one I'm using now. I bought the orthopedic bed that is going to correct itself, but it will still be occurring. So if I just undo any hard object, that is still going to affect me. Even the internal organ, which is connecting the nervous system and everything, is affecting me up to now. I couldn't, if they call me from this side, I would think they are calling me from, I couldn't hear with this side of the ear. And the ear is making noise up to now. After some treatment, after some ear syringing they've done at my Lagos State Teaching Hospital in Lagos State. I was posted to a financial company at Ikeja after my relocation down to Lagos. I couldn't even go there because even the MD refused to assess me because he was talking, I couldn't hear what he's saying. I only hear from this side, I couldn't hear from this side. And even told me he can't assess me, that I'm having a medical issue. I just pleaded, I begged the man severally I begged him, I'll come back later to just accept me first so that I can do my documentation after being relocated from Kebbi State to Lagos State. I don't think I'm employable anywhere. Even during interviews that I've participated in, they are not interested in most of them will request for my medical report. They are not interested in my case because I couldn't hear very properly. The doctor said he would not lie to me that if I want to hear, I need to travel down to abroad, maybe India or so. You can be able to get me back to normal. And even my lifespan has been shortened because of my present situation that is still going to bounce back. Even my chest fracture, that if I just, maybe I now slept on my chest or anyhow, it's going to affect me the following morning. After graduating from school, I learned plumbing work, which I even believe this is what I'm going to be doing. But for now, I don't even have the power to hold anything heavy object or hammer or something like that. The money I spent on my personal self in health issue, I spent up to 1.2 million naira from the private hospital. I spent 203,300 naira in the public hospital last week. So after spending this money, I go to NYC to submit my medical bills letter. Now they should refund the bills. But they told me that they cannot accept private medical bill, that I should submit the only public hospital bill. And that is the one I presented to them, and they'll be able to pay 185,050 naira from out of that 203,300. You know, I personally have borrowed money from a private financial service company. My parents have given out money, my uncles, they've tried for me. And now it's all just as if I'm alone, I don't have anybody. And I know, I believe I'm a Nigerian, I've worked for my country so that other people will know that the government really cater for the youth after participating in a particular duty, which especially the INEC duty. So I'm pleading to the government. They should just assist me to take further medical attention. If it is providing job to take care of myself, keep money so that I can continue my life and take care of my family so that I will not become, be depressed. That could actually lead to something that I don't pray for. Please, you should just help me.